Hey guys and gals, what's going on? Dan the Man coming at you from the 60s Rule Channel. And before we get going with this guy over here, we got shout out time again. Yep, go check this guy out, Mike's Mods and Customs, man. He's a cool dude, man. He collects and restores Hot Wheels and diecast, man. He's got a cool channel over there. So go over there and check him out, man. Give him a like, give him a sub. Ring his doorbell, tell him he's cool, and tell him Dan the Man sent you. All right? Mike's Mods and Customs. So any of you guys who are into Hot Wheels and that kind of stuff, highly recommend this guy. All right, guys. Now, let's talk about this guy here, the Flash Cat. Yeah, I know. Don't bitch and complain about removing Flash. Actually, it doesn't bother me. It's all part of modeling, you know. We got to improvise and overcome. You know, the model's not going to build itself, so. But anyway, she came out really nice, and, well, let's see what we got. There she is, guys. Look at this. This thing can fit in the palm of my hand. Let's give it a quick little spin around over here. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to take this thing off the stand because, man, this thing is so damn small. And I tell you what, to show you how small this is, I'm going to use this other tea bucket for comparison. We're going to put this guy right next to our tiger cat there just to show you the difference in size. This is a 1/24 scale tea bucket I built for Fred Henry appreciation build. And this is the 32nd scale. I mean, look at the difference, man. I mean, a lot of small parts, you know, and it was a tedious assembly, but, you know, you take your time and you get some good results, man. So look at the difference in size. Unbelievable, huh? Yeah, let's move this guy out of the way, and then let's concentrate on this guy over here. Yeah, she came out pretty good. I'm going to take this off. Hang on, guys. We'll just get a closer look over here. So we painted this guy with lemon yellow, and I told you I was going to put some decals on it, and I tell you, I was so preoccupied with doing all the other, you know, little detailed work. This totally slipped my mind because these pipes, I wanted to use everything in a kit, and the pipes come up this way, you know, diagonally, and that's exactly where I put the decal. And as I'm assembling the model, I'm like, I don't know. I was going to take these pipes off and put different ones on, and I said, no, you know what? I'll just leave it because the decal's almost on the same angle as the pipes. So, yeah, we just left it there. So, and everything on this kit was not chromed. It didn't come with any glass or any chrome. So I chromed everything you see there. The headers, the radius arms, even the windshield frame I chromed. And the scoop that came on the engine, actually, I borrowed that from the other kit I'm working on, the 56 Ford. They had a drag version that had two of these scoops over here, so I took one out and I just sized it up and I said, boy, that looks pretty cool. So yeah, we went with that. And the distributor, actually, it's a 1/24 scale distributor. It looks a little out of scale. I tried sanding it down the base, you know, a little bit so it would just blend in, but I got it to work. So I mean, those wires are 0.4 millimeter, you know, on 24th scale, so you would probably need like 0.3 millimeter or 32 gauge wire. I had 30 gauge wire laying around, and it's basically the same size as the 0.4 mil, so I didn't have any wire, so I went with this, but we made it work. And then I did a scratch built coil and just painted it black, threw it on a firewall, so it looks like it's doing something there. And those valve covers are pretty cool. I don't know if you can see that or not, but it does say Corvette on there. So it's a 283 block there with the Corvette valve covers. So, I mean, for a kit from 1965, not bad detail. I mean, it came with a complete engine, you know. So yeah, and then the front end, I put my own grill in the front there. I didn't use the headlights, they were plastic, just lenses. So what I did was I took a chrome pen and did the inside of the buckets, the headlight buckets, and then put some Mod Podge clear in there. So that worked out pretty well. And I did the same thing with the inside of the grill, put a little grate there. And the hoses are all scratch built. I did a how-to video on it a long time ago, so you can go to my archive, see how I did that. So we got an upper and lower radiator hose there. Worked out nice. And let's move on to this interior. This was time consuming over here, I tell you. What I did, you can see the dash. All those dash faces and bezels are from Model Car Garage. So what I did was I shaved off all the raised numerals that were on a dash until I had a flat surface. Then I painted the whole dash with some flat silver, and then we applied those gauges. I don't know if I can get a close up. I guess that's about, let me see if I can zoom in a little more. Let's try zooming in. There you go. Yeah, that came out pretty nice. And yeah. Oh, too much, too much. There we go. And then we painted the seat belts and the buckles there. And then the steering column, I didn't like the one that came with the kit, so I put a piece of aluminum tubing there. And the shifters from the kit, painted the ball white there. So yeah, pretty nice. And then we got the moon tank in the back over there that came with the kit. And yeah, guys, I mean, overall, I mean, for a kit, you know, it's over 50 years old and had a shitload of flash. Not bad at all. Not bad at all, guys. I tell you, a lot of guys tend to, you know, veer away from these 32nd scale kits, man. I tell you, if you take your time, you know, and you can do a lot of detail to these models, man. They come out really, really nice, you know. Guys like, you know, they always shying away from 32, but like I said, man, you know, have fun with these kits, man. There's a lot of detail you can put in there if you really just take your time and use your imagination, you know. So yeah, let me show you what the next project is. Let's put him on the side. Sean said I could build as many kits as I want, so this is going to be next up on the bench. This pyro, like I said, I got a boatload of these. Uh-oh, boatload? No pun intended. It's a boat tail. Yeah, so we're going to do this guy next. Let me put this back in the holder here. Let's take a look at it real quick. And yeah, this is really neat. They got a lot of information on the side over there, the history of the company. So that's pretty cool. And then well, you can see right over here, Pyroplastics 1965. Then on this side, right over here, it says chrome finish button, and then it says authentic automobile color. Now, I don't know if they're referring to the box art, because inside the kit, let's open this up, it's all molded in this green, this bright green color over here. So I think they're referring to this over here, the box art, because I looked online for some reference photos, 1930 Packard, and I didn't see any metallic ones like this. So, I mean, they used a lot of different colors like Johan did. You never know what the color's going to be. So, but anyway, it's a nice kit, man. It's all complete, everything's there. I bagged up all the loose parts. All the chrome is still bright. It's really, really nice kit. It's got nice rubber tires in there. I don't know if they're rubber. Maybe vinyl, but they're all in good shape. Yeah, really, really cool stuff, man. And here's the instruction sheet over here. So, yeah, and then you got written instructions too, which I really appreciate. So I think I'm gonna paint it this color here. I like that color there. That's like a, it's like an off yellow, almost like a butterscotch. And then the fenders, the ones I've seen a couple of packages like this online, And the fenders, it was like this dark red, almost like a burgundy color. So I think I'm gonna go with this paint scheme here. It's really cool, really classy. So yeah, we got the Packard Boattail. It's next up on the bench, guys. It's gonna be a fun build, boy. 32nd scale, right in my wheelhouse. All right, let's put this guy back over here. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. And it was a lot of fun building this guy over here. And until next time, guys, take care, be safe, and keep on building.